next morning.
I have a message that I'm preaching this morning that is going to be not just for this local church. I have a message this morning that will move beyond this local church to the entire Christendom, to the entire Nigeria, cutting across every political, geopolitical, ethnic community in this nation, Nigeria. And I have a message that is sweeping across nations of Africa. And I have a message this morning that will zoom into Europe, United States, and throughout the northern hemispheres and the southern hemispheres of this planet. We have troubles in our world. And this trouble cannot necessarily be addressed by the UNO. This trouble cannot be addressed by the African Union. It cannot be addressed by the European Union. The problem can only be addressed only and absolutely only by the authentic, infallible, inherent Word of God that can never change. Shall we bow our heads? Ancient of days, sanctify thy word. Thy word is truth. Hide me behind the cross. May I never speak my word. May your glory come upon me and interpret. And may every soul that will hear this voice be under conviction by the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Like what I was saying. You see, sometimes. Let me put it this way. People. Some families are divided. Husband against wife and wife against husband. In some places, the battle is drawn between the boss and the would-be settled servants. Troubles. You begin to see trouble between church and church. You see that churches are in daggers drawn with one another. In some places you see pastor versus pastor. The market man versus his neighbor. The business colleague. At conflict with the other person. And sometimes you see bishop versus bishop. Something came to my mind as I was talking. I remember church history. There was a time they went to council, one of the councils. This bishop came to the council meeting with a thug. And the other bishop came to the council meeting with his own talk. Today, what do we see? As you open the CNN,
dịka ị na-emeghe ebe eche ego okwu nke bụ CNN,
you see nations at conflict.
E wee hụta ọtụtụ nzukọ, ọtụtụ obodo ka ha nọ na nsogbu dị iche iche.
We have war-torn nations.
E nwere ọtụtụ obodo ebe e nwere ọtụtụ ibu agha dị iche iche.
We see eruptions of rebels.
Wee na-ahụ ọtụtụ ihe mgbawa na nnupụ isi dị iche iche.
Rebels from various nations.
Ọtụtụ nnupụ isi nke si n'obodo nile dị iche iche.
And let me say this.
Ka m wee kwuo nke a.
Except God intervenes.
Ọ bụ na Chineke emeghị ihe.
Nigeria is coming to a boiling point.
N'eche, Nigeria na-abịa n'ogo nke ya onwe ya ga-asụ dịka mmiri ọkụ.
Hear it again.
N'onye ọzọ.
If you like, call it prophetic.
Ya masị gị, kpọọ ya okwu nke ọma.
Except God intervenes.
Ọ bụ na Chineke emeghị ihe.
We are coming to a boiling point.
Anyị na-abịaru n'oge ihe nhụju anya nke obodo a.
We see rancor.
Anyị na-ahụ esemokwu.
Interparty rancor and intraparty rancor.
N'ese, site n'otu pati nke a baa n'ibe ya, enweghị nkwekọrịta.
But I hear God speak to my heart clearly.
Ma anụ m ka Chineke kwuru okwu nye obi m.
Speak to these people.
Ya sị, gwa ndị a okwu.
Speak to every family.
Gwa ọtụtụ ezinụlọ nọ n'ebe ahụ okwu.
Speak to every church.
Gwa nzukọ dị iche iche okwu.
Speak to every nation.
Gwa obodo dị iche iche okwu.
Talk, say the Lord.
Otu a ka Jehova nke eluigwe sịrị.
Put back your sword into the sheath.
Weghachi mma gị n'ọgbọ ya.
Put back your sword into the sheath.
Meghachi mma gị n'ọgbọ ya.
And my message this morning says,
ozi m kụtụtụ a na-asị,
let everybody hear.
Ka mmadụ niile nụrụ.
Every lover of peace.
Onye ọbụla nke hụrụ udo n'anya.
If you want to do the will of God.
Ọ bụ na ị chọrọ ime uche nke Chineke.
If you want to do the purpose of God.
Ọ bụ na ị chọrọ ime ihe nke Chineke.
Thus says the Lord.
Otu a ka Jehova sịrị.
Put back your sword.
Meghachi mma gị n'ọgbọ.
Put back your sword.
Meghachi mma gị n'ọgbọ ya.
I see men and women.
Nwoke na nwanyị.
They have drawn their sword.
Ha ewepụtala mma ha.
Brother against brother.
Nwoke megide
sister. Sister against sister.
Na nwanyị megide
church against church.
Nzukọ megide nzukọ.
Party against party.
Megide party.
Family against family.
Ezinụlọ megide ezinụlọ.
But I hear the voice of God.
Ma ọnụ nke Chineke.
Put back your sword.
Meghachi mma gị n'ọgbọ.
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 We have a problem.
Anyị nwere nsogbu.
Go to the village.
Gaa n'obodo.
They kill one another with poison.
Ha na-egburita onwe ha.
Go to the market.
Gaa n'ebe na-azụ ahịa.
They put juju in the market.
Ha na-eje ọgwụrụ ha. Gaa ahịa.
They want to eliminate partners.
N'ese, ha chọrọ ka ha wezuga onye otu ha.
They want to eliminate people who are doing well.
Ha chọrọ ka ha wezuga ndị na-eme nke ọma.
Because of that.
N'ihi nke a.
They went to occultic homes.
Ha wee gaa ebe a na-eke ọgwụ.
They went to so-called prayer house.
N'ese, ha gaa ụlọ ekpere.
Because of that.
N'ihi nke a.
They get into champs.
N'ese, ha na-eje ọgwụ ka ọma ha.
Listen to me.
Gee ntị ugbu a.
Do you want to live?
Ọ bụ na ị chọrọ ịdị ndụ.
Do you want to see good days?
Ị chọrọ ka ị hụ ụbọchị ọma?
Talk, say the Lord.
Otu a ka Jehova sịrị.
Put back your sword.
Meghachi mma gị.
Put back your sword.
Meghachi mma gị n'ọgbọ ya.
If you don't put it back.
Ya bụ na ị weghachi ya.
It will turn as a weapon.
Ese, ọ ga-atụgharị bụ ihe mmegide wee nye gị.
If you don't put it back.
Ya bụ na ị meghachi gị ya.
Listen to me.
Gee ntị nke ọma.
I don't know what you have hidden.
Amaghị m ihe gị onwe gị kụrụ ụkwụ.
I don't know where you have put your hands.
Amaghị m ebe ị tinyere aka gị.
I don't know.
Amaghị m.
You sleep in the burial ground.
Ese, ị hiri ụra n'ebe a na-eli ozu.
Because of somebody.
Maka otu mmadụ.
You slept in the desert.
Ị wee hie ụra n'ọzara.
Because of somebody.
N'ihi mmadụ.
You went to the ocean.
Ị gara n'osimiri.
Because of somebody.
N'ihi mmadụ.
You buried a live animal.
Wee were anụ dị ndụ lie ya.
Because of somebody.
N'ihi mmadụ.
I speak to you this morning.
Ana m
agba ọkụ. By the authority of the word of God. And the anointing of God's spirit.
Ọ bụ nke mmadụ Chineke.
Your days are counted.
N'ese, a gụrụ ụbọchị gị ọnụ.
Talk, say the Lord.
Otu a ka Jehova sịrị.
If you want to be delivered.
Ya bụ na ị chọrọ ka a napụta gị.
From the looming doom.
Na ihe egwu nke gaje bịa.
Put back your sword.
Meghachi mma gị n'ọgbọ.
Before I read the Bible.
Tupu m agụọ akwụkwọ nsọ.
You know, in correct exegesis, that's correct prayer. principle of biblical interpretation.
Nese no okuru kedi mese me yede konso siri kawaya.
Now hear me, church.
Kente nzuka.
That something was recorded in the Bible does not mean that God has approved of that action.
Nese ne deri ihe na akwonso aputaghi na Chineke na asi na ihe adi mma.
Is somebody hearing me?
Nani ha na ekwu?
Did you hear what I said?
You know, he had a clue.
That somebody, something had been written.
Does
not mean that God approved of that action.
They say, na keko si na iya nkeji edere ni iya menejiri de ya na osi nesi na ya Chineke.
I saw in the Bible.
Ahurum na akwanso.
Holy men made mistakes in the Bible.
Otundi di so ha meri iya meku na akwanso.
Yet it was recorded.
Ma ede kwara ede.
Is it for us to do it? Because they did it. If it were today, certain mistakes in the Bible wouldn't have been written. Because we want to save the credibility of that great man of God. Let me give you an instance. Go to every burial ceremony. What kind of testimony do we receive? Have you ever heard where they said, they picked the microphone, this man that has been buried today was a terrible man. He was a criminal. A 419er. People can say that at the back, but not publicly. And no matter what you say at the back, that thing that they said with the microphone is the official one. And in a lot of interpretation, you don't build a doctrine, a rule for practice, based on a single sighting in the Holy Writ.
Nese na iwu nke nkọwa nke ihe mmadụ agaghị eme ka ihe bụrụ ihe naanị na ihe nke otu onye ji anya ya hụ.
Well, interpreter, I don't know what you would do with that. But you don't build a doctrine based on one verse of the Bible.
Nese, ị gaghị eme ka e nwee ihe nkwenye naanị site n'otu ihe nke ị hụrụ n'akwụkwọ nsọ.
Go with me to Matthew 26.
Soro m gaa n'akwụkwọ Matthew, isi iri abụọ na isii.
Verse 47.
Amoku nke iri anọ na asaa.
Matthew 26 verse 47.
Akwa Matthew iri abụọ na isii, amoku nke iri anọ na asaa.
Are you there?
Una chọtala ya?
While he was still speaking.
Dịka ọ na-ekwu okwu.
There are people, when they see you, how they greet you is to spit on your face.
O mọrọ tun ni mara ọ ga-abụ mgbe ha hụ otu a ga-esi kelee gị bụ igbu ha asụ mmiri n'iru.
Yes. I'm sure of what I'm saying from cultural anthropology perspective. There are others. When they see you, they do like this. They don't want to have body contact. Because they believe in caste system. Now that is like Osu syndrome. They believe that when they touch somebody of a lower class, it can defile them. So they don't know whether you're of a higher or lower. To avoid that mistake, they simply do like this. Just in Nigeria, here in Yoruba, they prostrate to show what? Respect. It doesn't mean they are idol worshippers. It's simply their cultural way of respecting somebody. In other places, they shake hands as a sign of greeting. Others are huggers. They hug as a sign of greeting. Others will kiss. They will peck you, you know, give you a peck. Some conscience, they peck you at the cheek, peck you at the cheek, give you one at the central region. Now, when the Bible says, he came, master, he kissed. Ordinarily, you will say, what a love. What a free heart. But in truth, it was a sign to signify the man he wants to kill. I don't know why you have come to visit the person in the hospital. Is it to see how far he has died, the extent he is dying, and how many minutes he remained for him to die? The man you had that fire raised his shade, and you went to visit his shade. Did you go to sympathize, or you were there to make sure, to confirm that everything in that shade went to blessings?
Giga kileta ya babu kiwa igoso miko mabu kitopata nese mwakwa habari hini loji ibiri nukwata kwata neba.
Hypocrites have come to the world.
Aina huta no tundi rwa abu adela nuwa.
How are you, ma?
Hello, Twidi. Is in them.
Good morning, Sata.
Good morning. Ime ototo ama oyana asopro.
But in their hearts.
Manobi ha.
When they move out.
Yabuna hapua.
They will do like that.
Asegi chirekwa isen.
People who have come to betray their master with kiss. Polluted kiss. Judas!
Judas!
He had arranged people to come and arrest the master. Yet he came. Displaying an apparent love. Going at once, he said, greetings, Rabbi.
Yes, Kelonya na Saporo.
But he was dealing with somebody that was more than a man.
Mama gina onye na mekori hebo onye kare maduku.
Jesus replied,
Jesus we say,
friend,
eni,
do what you came for.
Iya nkibi la makaya meya.
Others may be deceived by this your kiss. But I know why you came. Stop deceiving people. Tell your neighbor. Drop thy mask. Speak to your neighbor. Tell your neighbor. Drop thy mask. Say it again to that person. I'm getting ready for that message titled Drop Thy Mask. For masquerades have come to church. Masquerades have come to church. Fire of revival is about.
The
wind of revival will blow. It will uncover every masquerade. I said, it shall uncover every masquerade. It shall uncover every masquerade. Masquerade have come to. Masquerades. Masquerade in the choir. Masquerade on the pulpit. Masquerade in the congregation. But listen, time is coming. And it is now. I hear a sound. A sound of revival. I hear a wind. A wind of revival. It's going to blow across the church. It shall move in the congregation. As when it comes, every masquerade shall be dropped. Every masquerade shall be exposed. Every masquerade shall come to open. Every masquerade shall come to open. He said, Judas,
Judas, it's Judas.
You have pretended enough.
Imela manamana niro.
Come and do what you came for.
Mele kibya la makaya.
Ask your neighbor, what did you come for?
Oya bato di gisi agini kibya la makaya.
Ask everybody in this church. Christianity has come to a radical junction. You must declare what you came for. Who are you?
Onye kebo.
Money seeker. Husband seeker. Position seeker. Agent. Dividing the church. Are you? What is your name? Where do you come from? What is your identity? What did you come for? Don't tell me your position. What is your assignment? Who sent you? Is it demon? Is it devil? Is it your community? Why are you here? I don't care what you're doing. Why are you here? Why are you hidden? Listen to me. Time has come. Every hidden cockroach will manifest. Time has come. Every hidden rat will manifest. Every hidden snake might manifest. Everything. There must be a manifestation. There must be a manifestation. Judas.
Judas.
Do what you came for.
May I be a Makaya?
For the time of hypocrisy will soon expire.
Nina, okay, kiru aboga, kusi mena diganya.
And the men stepped forward.
Ndiaweganiru.
Seize Jesus.
Where did they Jesus?
Seize the man that he told others is his master.
Where did they
betrayed the master with a kiss.
Where na yuku sera sutuano?
As a result.
Dika.
One of Jesus' companions.
Onye so Jesus neighbor who to name her.
Well, some people say it's Peter.
Atoni ma usenabu Peter.
Peter said.
Peter we say.
Umu namga neighbor alenke eri ekwam ni humga.
Ah, will I stay here? And this kind of thing will happen.
Mba we better amka na church.
Ah, Christianity is not up to that.
He pulled his sword.
Yawe we put amma ya.
Abutan na Peter jenom ma da church.
Does it mean that Peter came to the church with a sword?
You know there are people.
All right, stand them madam.
When they sit down,
behano ala,
cover their ears and cover their eyes. Clock their nose with the head.
We kuchete anu iru anaya. We open ari ata. We kenolu.
You don't know what is in their pocket.
Magi head in akpa ha.
You don't know what is in their heart.
Magi head in obi ha.
Peter came to church with a sword.
Peter jima we biana suka.
He pulled it.
Yami putaya. Get in olum.
Put your sword back in its place.
Lea simma geno boya.
Put your sword back to its place.
Lea simma geno boya.
Put your sword back to this place.
Lea simma geno boya.
For all who draw the swords.
Makandil lendi mi putaramma.
All. Who draw the sword shall die by the sword. All who draw the sword. All who draw the sword shall die by the sword. Come on.
Yeah.
Do you think that I cannot call on my
father?
And he will at once put at my disposal more than 12 legions of angels. My brethren, when I read this, I said, then the whole world will finish. Now, why did I say that? One angel alone killed how many? How many? 185,000.
Mm-hmm.
then you are not talking of legions, two wife legion. What is one legion?
Venerable to legion.
Now he was talking about, can't I ask my father for him to send two wife legion? This kind of spirit of drawing the sword was also in the disciples. I was reading somewhere in the Holy
Bible.
In Luke 9. Look at what happened there. Luke chapter 9. Verse 51. As he was going, there was Samaritan opposition. And in Luke 9:51, as the time approached for him to be taken up to heaven, Jesus resolutely set out for Jerusalem.
Jesus, where now I got Jerusalem?
He sent messengers ahead. Messengers are here who went into Samaritan village to get things ready for him. But the people there did not welcome him because he was heading for Jerusalem. You know, this kind of sentiment. Now, look at verse 54. When the disciples, James and John, saw this,
James and John,
when they saw it,
they
said, you mean you are opposing our master? Lord of lords. Christians.
D.K. Christ.
Let's be careful that our loyalty and zeal for Christ do not conceal a spirit of revenge or violence against those who are not yet
saved.
Now, where did they borrow this? Let me go back to the old. Brethren, I respect
Elisha.
Elisha had a big anointing. But if you ask me to judge, immediately he received the double portion. The thing was intoxicating him. That he was going. Small children calling him bad head.
Elijah, oh, you see, Potter. Elijah, when you see Pacha, when you see Pacha, Elisha,
this man,
Moka.
In short, I don't just want to be so much in a hurry.
I told him, Cambrega, no, now,
look at it.
Leia,
Second Kings,
come on, there's a couple.
2:23. In the same chapter that he received the double portion.
2:23.
You see, when Elisha went up to Bethel,
as
he was walking along the road, some youths came out to town and jeered him. Go on up. You bad head. He turned around. Is this not the double anointing I have received? Double portion. And he said,
Yahweh say,
he looked at them. Call down a curse on them.
Yahweh,
in the name of the Lord. Then the Bible says, two bears came out of the woods and mauled 42 of the youths.
Hey!
Church, the anointing you have is so great. God will honor your word. But be careful. 42
pence.
Simply because they called the man of God a bad head.
Nani na ha kwara onye isi nkwata onye nke Chineke.
It didn't stop there.
Akwụsịghị n'ebe ahụ.
You know, last time I came, I preached about uncompromising standard. I talked about Gehazi. I blamed Gehazi. But look at, yes, I blamed Gehazi. But Elisha, Oku to Mua.
The same spirit.
1, 2, 3. The leprosy of Naaman. Shall never depart from you.
He
didn't even stop with
Elijah.
And your descendants. He invoked what I call generational curses. And the man, you know, himself departed from his master. Double portion. Gehazi departed from him. Leprosy and the cost.
Elisha, boy, yes, in Eben, you could not put up. When you were the man who cooked, Babo, my Gehazi, boy, your fellow of faith. Sinebon or poor, Brony, Pentagas, Sochi, Yabonari, Aboria.
Elisha finished, died with his anointing without raising a successor.
Eman and Elisha, Lutaroli, and what? They were put a one against Sochiazo.
There are people with that kind of spirit. My son will never come up. Let me ask you. Whom have you raised? Whom have you raised? Who have ever served you and become a better person? Who have ever served you? Who? You know, I was reading an account. It was interesting, but somehow, the man so died with his anointing. How do I know? Even the time people were passing by, suddenly, the corpse fell on Elijah. Because he died with his anointing. He didn't transfer power to any person. The thing, while Orela, Opopoya, Nona, the anointing still worked. Let me tell you. What God has handed over to you is a mighty weapon at your disposal. But don't pull sword. Put back your sword. Put back your sword. Peter says.
Peter, where is he?
John and brother said.
John, you and James, where is he?
Master.
Now you go.
Let's call on fire.
Can you put to our cursor anywhere?
The fire might consume them.
Can you call where so to our lip, yeah?
Don't misuse that.
Because a medical line of the rica.
We have a problem.
I will also do.
Somebody has offended you.
Madu, Pastor Giwe.
What do I do?
Give me
at this. My husband has offended me.
Dim pastor
me, I can't spare him.
Me happy.
I won't agree. Listen. God is saying. What I'm preaching this morning is a hard message. It doesn't agree with culture. Because the culture says. Ugobere.
Let Ugo bet. Ebebere Ugobere.
Nkasi beyebere. Nkukwaya. Somebody told me they have modified it. And they are saying, Ebebere Ugobere. Nkasi beyebere.
Okasi ebagebe. Okasi ebagebe.
I know that we are living in the world.
I'm not in the anymore.
But let me say this. If the cultural philosophy, the worldly philosophy, the worldly norm becomes an influence over Christian practice, then we have delved into a delicate, dangerous state of spiritual comatose.
emera ka ihe jiri mara ikpere Chineke bụrụ ihe wezugara gị mara n'ezie na ikpere Chineke abaala n'ọnọdụ ọjọọ nke ihe egwu chere ya n'iru.
Forgiveness remains a virtue in Christendom.
Abunari ibahara mmadụ bụ ihe nke a na-anụzi n'ọnụ.
If you don't forgive,
ya bụ na ibahara gị,
the root of bitterness will continue to be there.
Ị ga-ahụ na mkpụrụ nke ilu ga-abụ ihe ga-anọgide n'obi gị.
If you have never forgiven me,
ya bụ na ibahabere m,
even as I'm talking,
dịka m ga na-ekwu,
you will still feel like my falling here.
Ị ga-asị unu hapụ nwoke a ka okwu chapụọ.
The root of bitterness,
mkpụrụ nke ihe ilu.
If you don't forgive,
ya bụ na ibahara gị,
you put yourself in bondage.
N'ese ị ga-etinye onwe gị n'ọnya.
Yes, I know.
Amara m.
Somebody has broken your heart.
No, mela mmadụ tiwara obi gị.
Oh my God. And now people here this morning.
Mmadụ nụrụ okwu a n'ụtụtụ a.
There are men and women here whose hearts have been broken.
Oh, otu ụmụ okorobịa na ụmụ agbọghọbịa na ndị na-ndị etiwagboro obi ha.
Somebody broke your heart.
Mmadụ etiwala obi gị.
I said somebody broke your heart.
Mmadụ emela ka obi gị gbaa ọbara.
What shall we do?
Gịnị ka anyị ga-eme?
My heart is broken.
Obi metiwago ya.
And you vow.
You wee nwee iyi.
I will not let go.
Si agaghị m ahapụ ya n'ọnọdụ a.
Until death do us part.
Ruo mgbe ikpe anyị ekpere ya n'eluigwe ma ruo mgbe m nwụrụ.
This thing has done unto me.
Ihe nke I mere m.
Is obiri n'aja ọcha.
Ọ bụ n'aja ọcha ka ọ ga-akwụsị.
Obiri n'aja ọcha.
Ruo mgbe anyị ga-anwụ.
And with that kind of heart.
Site n'obi dị otu a.
You take holy communion.
I wee na oriri nsọ.
With that type of heart,
sir, obi dị otu a,
you still be a worker.
Gị bụrụ onye ọrụ nke nzukọ.
With that type of heart,
sir, obi dị otu a,
you still be a pastor.
Gị bụrụ onye na-ekwusa.
With that type of heart,
sir, obi dị otu a,
you eat communion together.
N'ese gị na ndị mmadụ erikọ oriri nsọ.
Hypocritical communion.
Onye iru abụọ, iri abụọ, oriri nsọ nke iru abụọ.
Because you won't let go,
n'ihi na ị pụghị hapụ ya,
you become a hunter.
Gị wee bụrụ onye nta, onye na-achụso mmadụ.
You know, hunters set traps.
Ehi hụrụ na ndị na-achụ nta ha na-etinye ọnya dị iche iche.
Do you know there are some church members who are setting traps?
Ị ma na o nwere otu ndị nzukọ ndị na-etinye ọnya?
There are outsiders who are setting traps.
O nwere ndị nọ na mbara ezi ndị na-etinye ọnya.
Even they say it publicly.
Ha na-ekwu ya na mpụta ihe.
The day you will enter my trap.
Ee, ụbọchị ị ga-adaba n'ọnya m.
If anybody says that,
ọ bụ na mmadụ ekwuo nke a,
tell the person,
gwa ya,
thank you, Mr. Hunter.
Ya, I meela ọchụ nta.
Thank you, Brother Hunter.
Ọchụ nta nwanna nwoke.
Thank you, Sister Hunter.
Nwanna nwanyị onye nwere mmaka si ọchụ nta imeela.
You see somebody.
Ọrụ mmadụ.
You feel remorse.
Ee, obi gị aghị arpara n'ilu.
What am I saying?
Gịnị ka m na-ekwu?
Somebody might begin to say.
Mmadụ nwere ike na-ekwu nke a.
What about this young man?
Elee maka nwa okorobịa.
Who duped me?
Onye zuru m ori.
I made away with my business money.
Wee sota wee ego nke m ji azụ ahịa la.
Am I not supposed to pull a sword for
him? Ọ bụ na o kwesịghị na mmịpụtara mma m wee gbuo ya?
This man,
nwoke a,
who is busy carrying scandals against me.
N'ezie, onye ọrụ chiri arụ ikwutọ aha m n'ebe nle dị iche iche.
Am I not right to pull a sword against
him? Ọ bụ na o kwesịghị na mmịpụtara mma m?
A man,
nwoke,
who broke my engagement.
N'ezie, onye mere ka nkwekọrịta m nọ n'ụlọ di na nwunye tiwa.
Abandoned me.
Wee hapụ m.
Am I not supposed to pull a sword for him?
Ọ bụ na o kwesịghị na mmịpụtara mma n'ọnwa ọnọdụ a?
This city man.
Onye a nke bụ onye okenye.
He keep insisting that I be disciplined.
N'ezie, ya na-asị na o kwesịrị ka e meso m na nzukọ a.
Am I not supposed to pull a sword?
Ọ bụ na o kwesịghị na mmịpụtara ya mma?
This man accused me for what I know I didn't do.
Onye a nke bụ onye ebubo ihe m mara na m emeghị ya.
You won't test how Christian your heart is until you come face to face with somebody who accused you falsely and you have opportunity to imprison him. You have opportunity to take him to court. But because of Christ, he that wanted to kill you, finish you on earth. He that wanted to eradicate you and make a nonsense out of your credibility. And you lifted up your hands. Child, if you go to police, if you go to court, pursue the case, you can get money for libel. But because of Jesus, you put your sword back.
Ị ga-amapụta ihe ikpere Chineke ịbụ ruo mgbe gị onwe gị rutere n'iru n'iru. Ọ bụrụ na onye ahụ nke ebiliri ime gị, nke zuru gị ori, nke mere gị ihe nle dị iche iche, n'ezie wee ruo na ya onwe ya dabatara n'ọnya nke kwesịrị na I gburu ya maọbụ tinye n'ụlọ nga maọbụ mesịa dịka ọnọdụ nke iwu siri dị, ma n'ihi Kraịst na ọnwụ nke obe ni bara chineke nkiti omoyi nime ya iwe elanya niru ya si ni Christ aga mahapu gini ye dotua.
A man broke the church.
Onye nketi wa suka
took the church away.
We kwa suka po
took our building even.
Nese we na hula.
Don't we pull the sword?
Abna ekwesiri mi putara yamma.
You mean that the general overseer is still saying I forgive him in advance?
Na onye kene le kata nzuka akpamkom no na asi na m ga ba hara ya bu na riyo di niru.
Thus says the Lord.
Otua ko onye wa iku.
Put back your sword.
Mi ati mage na obo ya.
For the battle, our warfare is not carnal.
Ne na ibu aga nka aga anyi obugi site na anu aro.
This is my mother-in-law.
Aga mu anya.
Mother-in-law.
Nedima.
Mother-in-law.
Nedim.
She's responsible.
Abu ya abu nye mene.
For a lot of havoc in my family.
Na ye ni ledi chichen kene menulam.
Pastor, should I not pull this?
Onye osatulam ne mekwesi mi putama. No, no, dear.
God is still saying.
Chikeneku.
Put back your son.
Me atim magen.
Vengeance is mine, say.
Abunari, mekwata di na kam otu akonye wa esere.
Vengeance is mine, says the Lord.
Mekwata di na kam otu akonye wa esere.
This father-in-law.
Nadim, Nadim.
This is my uncle.
Onye nke amo yana nem.
He killed my father through poison.
Oburu nnam stenansi.
Yes.
Eka bu esoku.
But God is saying.
Machineke na say.
Put back your son.
Mi atim magi na oboya.
This doctor killed my relation as a result of administration of a wrong drug. Don't I react? Thus says the Lord. Put back your thoughts. This man made a nasty comment about me. Put back your
sword.
This senior pastor does not want my progress. Put back your
sword.
This man, he made me lose this election. God says, put back your
sword.
Another hard one. I caught my partner in extramarital relationship. I had it. Pastor, am I not authorized now to direct and remark?
Pastor, do question I'm to put ya. Well, no one yosa, mabudi yosa.
Listen to what I'm saying. Put back your sword.
Me a tim mage. No, no, did you to?
Put back your
soul.
Let me announce. God cannot tell you to do an impossible thing, but he can tell you to do a hard thing. He does not give me money for food. Will I cook and he will enjoy? God says, put back your
sword.
Now let me say this before we run off. If you don't want to pull back your
sword,
look at what will happen to you. You cannot be happy. No genuine Christian can be happy in the process of retaliation. Let me announce. No genuine Christian can be happy in the process of retaliation. And the worst is that sometimes somebody you have something against may not even know that you have something against him, and you are dying and the person is enjoying.
That's
the right Igbo vocabulary. Osokos. In case you are hearing us and you've never heard this, this is one of the biggest vocabulary in Igbo language. Osokos. I like that. As long unless you are there with your sword, you can't have breakthrough. Listen to what I want to say now. Forgiveness is not an occasional act. It is a permanent attitude. It should be a part of you. Breathe in forgiveness, breathe out forgiveness, chew forgiveness, and let it be a portion of you. Friendship flourishes at the fountain of forgiveness. I said this the other time, let me repeat it for you. The greatest deliverance on earth is to go home, buy a fairly sized cemetery where you will bury the offenses of your husband, where you will bury the offenses of your wife, where you will bury the offenses of your brother. If you want to marry somebody that will not offend you, go to the cemetery and pick one in the mortuary. Oh yes. If you put it this way, it will remain like that. Put it this way, it will remain like that. Put it that way. Make it like this, it will remain like that. It will not offend you. But when you go and marry a human being, fully flesh, he must offend you. Listen. Member must offend pastor. Pastor must offend member. Children must offend parents. And parents must offend. Even government, listen. Government can offend the people they are leading. And the people they are leading can also offend the government. And if anybody be a governor, if anybody be a president, if anybody a head of state in any nation, you must have that kind of heart to absorb even offenses from the people that you are leading.
You're a leader.
And the people you are leading offended you. That's not why you should pull yourself. And you begin to kill. Because you are offended. How many times have you offended God? Did he kill you? Did he eradicate you? You have been offending God in the secret. You have been offending God in the open. And he has kept you alive. Because somebody offended you. You want to kill yourself. You want to kill, you want to fire, you want to kill the person. God says the Lord, put back your swords. Put back your swords. I said, put back your swords. You have to put back your swords. I say you got to put back your sword. Somebody must put back his sword. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I saw what David did. Saul was pursuing him with
that.
Wanting to eradicate him. There's something we call a man with living conscience. Somebody with living
conscience.
Somebody came to David. And when the time is almost gone, they said, Saul is here. David went.
David wega.
Oh my God. Opportunity to retaliate, but he pulled back. He secretly cut the tip of the rope.
Yet,
because he was a God-fearing person. The conscience spoke him. Conscience bought him only for cutting the clothes. They came again. Quoted the scriptures. This is the day that the Lord has made. That I will deliver your enemy into your hands. Give me a chance. Only one chance. I won't miss it. David is saying.
David, where you say?
God forbid. That I should lift up my
hand
against God's anointing. Bow your heads in prayer. There are people who have swords. They kept their family with a sword. Husband and husbands.
Friends,
be sincere this day. If you know there's a sword you have against somebody, stand up and come to the
altar.
Stand up from your seat. Walk out to this altar. We are not here to pretend. You know there is somebody who has broken your heart and you pulled your sword. You want to kill. You want to retaliate. You want to retaliate. Rise up from your seat. Come out to this altar. Thus says the master. Put back your sword.
Me a tim magenobo.
Put back your sword.
Me a tim magenobo.
When vengeance is sweet to you. When vengeance is sweet to you. You become a dead man in the church. Please, because of space, can you stand up so that others can come?
You cannot see me, oh, hey,
there is somebody here.
Oh, my mad neighbor.
You have a sword against your husband.
Hey,
a sword against your wife. A sword against your uncle. A sword against your family. A sword against your business partner. And the Lord Jesus is saying,
Jesus,
for my sake, for my name, for my
God,
put back your sword. I still give it a chance to come. For he that pulled the sword shall die by the sword. He that pulled the sword shall die by the sword. Brother, you are right. Humanly speaking, if you kill him, you are right. If you go to court, you will win the case. But
ma.
Jesus himself.
Jesus, the way
he says,
I say,
put back your sword. Put back your sword. Vengeance is mine, says the Lord. The battle is mine, says the Lord. Put back your sword. Oh my God. Put back your
sword.
Church. We go to pray for this world. Why do we have a war? People don't want to forgive. Why do we have a rancor and bitterness? People don't want to forgive. Why do we have hired assassins? People don't want to forgive. Let the church rise up.